Hello students, now in the next circuit what we are going to do is we will modify given fixed bias circuit. The reason behind this is the fixed bias circuit is not stable. Not stable in the sense the value of collector current is changing with respect to beta very often, and hence there has to be some modification in fixed bias circuit. Now you can see that this is modified fixed bias circuit. Let's see which part of the circuit is modified. You can easily see that at the emitter we have applied a resistor called as RE, which was previously absent. This is modification is done over fixed bias circuit. So question in your mind will be that what is use of RE? We know that RE will introduce negative feedback, but at the same time during DC analysis it will provide stability against beta, and hence we have add RE in the circuit. Now in order to perform DC analysis, what we need to find out is, first of all, step 1 to find out base current, step 2 to find out collector current, and step 3 to find out collector to emitter voltage. Are you getting this? The steps will remain same, only the circuit is modified and hence equation will change. Let's see that. So step 1 is to find base current IB, for which we will apply KVL to input, that is base to emitter. Now we will apply that. First point will be VCC minus IB into RB. Okay, for you I will mark the directions of the current. From RB IB will be flowing. Similarly from RC IC will be conducting. Okay, between base to emitter the voltage is called as VBE, and from collector to emitter it is called as VCE. Now the input equation will become VCC minus IBRB minus VBE minus IE into RE is equal to 0. Now there is a problem. Now you can see that in input side there are two current. One is base current IB and another is emitter current IE. This is a problem because we need to find out only base current. So what we'll do is we'll try to eliminate emitter current IE. How to do that? So I'll write, I know that, or even I'll say that we know that IE is equal to beta plus 1 time of IB. This is a relationship between emitter current and base current, where IE is equal to beta plus 1 times of IB. Now we will replace IE by beta plus 1 times of IB, and hence equation will become VCC. I'll write equation over here. The equation will become VCC minus IB into RB minus VBE minus beta plus 1 times of IB into RE is equal to 0. Again, what we'll do is we will take base current on the left hand side and voltage on the right hand side. Hence, equation will become IB into RB plus beta plus 1 times of IB into RE is equal to, these are two voltage terms, so it will be VCC minus VBE. What we'll do is we will take IB common on left hand side. So equation will become, IB into bracket RB plus beta plus 1 times of RE is equal to VCC minus VBE. simply what we have done is we have taken this IB constant. So inside bracket there will be RB plus beta plus 1 times of RE. And hence in next step what we will do is we will bring these resistors as a denominator to this. So on the left hand side it will be only base current IB, and hence equation of base current become IB is equal to VCC minus VBE divided by RB plus beta plus 1 times of RE. This is how we will get base current from input side. Now you know the second step. Second step is to find out collector current. So step 2, to find IC, where IC is given as beta times of IB. Now the step 3 is to find out VCE. For which apply KVL to output loop, that is from collector to emitter. Hence equation will become VCC minus IC into RC minus VCE minus IE into RE is equal to 0. Now again there is a problem. The problem is very simple. The problem is that again we are having two current. One is IC and another is IE. What we will do is we will eliminate IE in terms of IC. For that we know that IC is approximately equal to IE. Hence I can simply replace IE by IC. Hence equation becomes VCC minus ICRC minus VCE minus IC into RE is equal to 0, and hence at final step we will get that VCE is equal to VCC minus IC into bracket RC plus RE. So from step 3 we have got voltage between collector to emitter. Our Q points are VCE, at Q point is called as VCEQ, comma ICQ. So by performing this analysis, we have got Q point for modified fixed bias circuit. Thank you.